With COVID on campus, students may not know where to get tested. Find out where and when testing is available.
And the university celebrates women of color in psychology. See where you can find the exhibit.
And one university professor makes a passion project, how he helps celebrate the university's 150th.
Welcome to this Monday night edition of UATV. I'm Kai Kocher.
And I'm Maddie Dunn. Thank you for joining us. The Arkansas Department of Health reported one of its lowest COVID-19 numbers this year. Currently, the state saw a rise in active cases reaching 33,038. Hospitalizations fell to 1,477. The health department added 729 new cases to the state's account, with the state's death total rising by 36.
The ADH reported the state's new vaccination numbers. Over 1.6 million Arkansans are fully vaccinated, with over 4 million doses distributed to the state's immunization rate grew to nearly 53%. Washington County reached a total of over 129,000 fully vaccinated residents.
The university continues to host a clinic for COVID testing outside of the Union Mall. If anyone needs testing, they should complete a brief registration form. The clinic stays open Monday through Friday from 8 to 4 p.m. This clinic will remain on campus until next Friday.
The City of Fayetteville is hosting a blood drive this week. The Community Blood Center of the Ozarks, or the Blood Mobile, will be in downtown Fayetteville on Wednesday the 9th from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. The CBCO asks for all eligible donors to consider donating in order to help refill blood reserve levels since the snowstorm. You can schedule an appointment online at their website.
The university will host several events celebrating Black History Month. One of these events is the Black TikTok event. This aims to teach Black creators how to make engaging content on one of the leading social media platforms. This event takes place tomorrow at 6 in the Arkansas Union Ballroom.
The university will also host a Black Culture Night to celebrate Black History Month. This event will focus on celebrating Blackness and connecting students to Black resources on campus. The celebration will take place in the Union Ballroom from 6 to 8 p.m. on February 28th. A full calendar of events can be found on the university's Diversity and Inclusion website.
And the Black Action Collective hosts events celebrating Black History Month. This Wednesday, the Black Action Collective will host an event featuring readings from letters sent from a Birmingham jail. The video presentation will feature community leaders reading from the late Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s works. The event takes place at Crystal Bridges Wednesday at 7 p.m.
An Arkansas committee interviewed Emmett Till's cousin in remembrance of Till's life. Reverend Wheeler Parker Jr., cousin of Till, spoke with the Black Action Collective on the importance of Till's story. The Black Action Collective is an organization aiming to celebrate and affirm the rich history and resilience of the African American community in Northwest Arkansas. Interviews like this and more can be found at the organization's website, bacnwa.com.
The university hosts a new exhibit titled I Am Psyched. This multimedia exhibit focuses on the contributions that women of color give to psychology. The event will also feature the voices of feminists in psychology. The self-guided exhibit is now open and can be found in Memorial Hall until next Monday.
Online degree programs at the U of A earn high praise in the latest U.S. News and World Report. Online bachelor's degrees programs rank 16th in the best online programs for veterans, with two other groups ranking in the top 30. The annual report bases its rankings on how programs serve veterans.
One professor premieres a new documentary about the University of Arkansas. The new film, titled If This Walk Could Talk, is a collection of shared memories about the university's history. This film comes as part of the 150th celebration of the university.
And I began thumbing through those old Razorback and Cardinal yearbooks that go back to the early 1900s. And in every one of those yearbooks are little stories and lots of photos of the way students felt about the university then.
This documentary will be shown at the Faulkner Arts Center Thursday at 7 p.m.
A student-run business called Forever Red is selling Valentine's Day boxes for the third year in a row. Boxes include candy, snacks, a chocolate rose, Valentine's teddy bears, a heart-shaped balloon, and an option including a personalized message. Forever Red offers delivery or contactless pickup for Friday, February 12th between 12 p.m. and 5 p.m. at the Brewer Entrepreneurship Hub.
A local baker is baking for a cause once again. Macaroons for Yemen is donating its Valentine's Day profits for the second year in a row. 25% of the macaroon purchases will be donated to the Yemen Relief and Reconstruction Foundation. Flavors include raspberry lychee, cherry cordial, Earl Grey, brownie, and vanilla. Pricing can be found on Instagram at macaroons for Yemen.
And there is a new study being conducted on transgender experiences at the University of Arkansas's campus. This study's purpose aims to offer better insight into the diverse lives of university members. Survey respondents will be able to enter in a chance to win a $50 Amazon gift card. For questions about how to complete the survey, contact Taylor Hubbard in the School of Social Work.
A committee has been selected to find the university's next chancellor. Members of the committee will serve as advisors to U of A System President Donald Bobbitt. Dean of the College of Engineering, Kim Needy, will serve as the committee chair. In the coming weeks, the committee will look to advertise the position and recruit.
The Northwest Arkansas Humane Society waives all costs for dog adoptions. A popular dog food company, Blue Buffalo, has agreed to pay all adoption fees for the month of February. All dogs will be vaccinated, fixed, and chipped prior to adoption. If you have an interest in adopting, visit the NWA Humane Society website for a complete list of all the available dogs.
Rogers Short Film Festival tickets are now on sale. The festival takes place on March 4th to 6th. Attendees can choose between one-day and three-day passes. Ticket prices can be found on ArkansasPublicTheater.org.
Music lovers, get ready because Kenny Chesney is back. On June 30th, the 8-time CMA Entertainer of the Year will play at the Walmart Amp in Rogers. Tickets go on sale at 10 a.m. this Friday. For more information regarding tickets, visit the Walmart Amp's website. The president speaks out about the recent U.S. military raid. Coming up, we'll show you how it went.
Coming up, I'll be talking about the dangers of reporting live on site next on UATV.
When times get dark, we can't see the help that's all around us. Let 211 be your guiding light for help with food, healthcare, and other resources.
211, how can I help you?
Call 211 or visit 211.org. 211. Get connected. Get help.
My grandfather was part of the study, Alec Ware. And Frank Cooper just get educated about what went on with the study.
It's just amazing how people still don't know. And now they're comparing it to the COVID-19. It's not a comparison.
Due to the fact that they wasn't given treatments, things have changed now. I've been a nurse since 1981. I just started wanting to do something to give back, you know, after I found out what happened to my great-grandfathers.
And I made the decision that I was going to get the shot. That's the reason I'm doing it. I'm doing it for them. I'm doing it for myself. I'm doing it for my kids.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Worried about your friend but don't know how to reach out? could say how are you or get a fake tattoo. You could ask with an app if it works for you. You could chat with them in VR. It's all good if you think you should check in. Yeah, you should.
Whatever gets you talking.
Reach out to a friend about their mental health.
Whatever gets you talking.
Learn how you can help at seizetheawkward.org.
Hey world, I have a quick message. It's about safe driving. All right, let's go. Anytime you're driving, have the seatbelt buckled tight, both hands on the wheel and your phone out of sight. When not in your hand trying to text somebody back, because if you do, your car might get smacked. The moral of the story, just put your phone down. The people on the road will stay safe and sound. Put your phone down, put your phone down. People on the road will stay safe and sound. Yeah.
See us dream. See us remember. See us protest.
You matter. Your feelings matter. Your identity matters. Everything about who you are matters.
See us fight back. See us rebuild. See us shatter stereotypes. See us inspire. See us united. See us now.
Last week, ISIS leader Abu Ibrahim al-Hashimi al-Qurashi died after a U.S. military raid. The leader died as a result of a suicide bombing. There were an unconfirmed number of civilian casualties. No Americans were harmed. President Biden spoke from the White House to address the situation. The U.S. chose to use special forces to minimize civilian casualties.
The FBI continues investigations into the bomb threats that were directed at 17 HBCUs across the country last week. The threats were directed at historically black colleges and universities like Howard and Jackson State. Officials have released that the six persons of interest are juveniles. No devices were found on any of the school's grounds.
New Jersey's Governor Phil Murphy looks to end the statewide mask mandate in schools in New Jersey. Murphy serves as a member of the Democratic Party, and the move to end the mandate seems to many as a move towards normalcy. Delaware and Connecticut join New Jersey in the move. Murphy says there were multiple factors that influenced his decision.
Our case count, hospitalizations, the spot positivity rate, the rate of transmission are all dropping like a rock, number one. Number two, we're making progress with vaccinations of newly eligible groups, including kids. Three, we're optimistic that the under five group of kids will soon have become eligible. Fourthly, we know we have a little bit more latitude 4 weeks from now when this will be lifted in terms of a little bit better weather and ventilation options.
Despite the move, the White House has said they still recommend mask mandates for school districts.
Journalists around the world might encounter dangerous situations while on the job. UATV reporter Joshua Pineda tells us more on the dangers of reporting on site. Josh?
Thanks, Maddie. Sometimes as a reporter, we face the possibility of going live on site by ourselves. However, there may be a time where our worst fear comes alive. Now, I want to warn the viewers at home, this next clip, which was shot by WSAZ and published on Twitter, may be hard to watch.
I'm okay, Tim.
Now, if you guys continue to play that same clip, you'll hear her say, "That's live TV for you." But what you guys don't know is that she was by herself the entire time. Reporters are being sent out to do these stories, to do these live reports by themselves, and incidents like that occur. Future journalists looking to get in the field, like myself, don't want to have to worry about potentially being hit by cars or potentially being hit by something else. I had the opportunity to talk with UATV reporter Riley Birdwell, who shares a story that could have potentially gone south.
For me personally, I've had an experience with going out with a field producer whenever I was reporting here at the university, here in Fayetteville, where I feel relatively safe. And we were at the neighborhood Walmart, and there was this guy that was just making me really uncomfortable, kept following us around, videoing us. And I was really thankful that I was with somebody else in that moment, because if I were by myself, I think I probably would have not done the live shot.
I contacted KNWA multimedia journalist Tristan Hill, who gave me some advice if I were to ever find myself in a dangerous situation.
Ideally, you would park your car close by and not get too far from your car, so that way you have access to your phone, or you can lock yourself inside if you need to, or just whatever it might be, you know? So really the biggest thing is kind of just being aware of your surroundings and what's going on, and basically have an exit plan. You know, if something went bad and you do need to get out, where are you going to go? Who are you going to call? That sort of thing. So it's definitely a big consideration, and it's definitely a conversation that we've had.
Hill also mentions that although this horrible accident took place, it shouldn't stop you from pursuing your dreams and becoming a journalist. Reporting live for UATV, I'm Joshua Pineda. Maddie, back to you.
Tori Yorgi, the WSAZ reporter who was struck by the vehicle, sustained no injuries from the accident and is okay.
Coming up, see which local favorite was nominated to the Food Hall of Fame.
And what changes are coming to Fayetteville's flora and fauna, coming up on UATV.
When I was your age, I was just like you, fascinated by stars. But now I get to search for life in the universe. And who knows, maybe life is looking for us too.
So we're like aliens to them?
Yeah. Does anyone want to be a scientist now?
I do.
Awesome, we need more girls in STEM.
Maybe we can find aliens.
As a former Razorback and NBA player, I know what it means to be strong defensively. You can help your team win. When it comes to COVID-19, your best defense is a COVID-19 vaccine. Getting the vaccine makes you a true team player, helping protect those people around you, especially those at high risk. So when it's your turn, don't miss your shot. I know I didn't.
Every day,
millions of people are connecting.
Father. Cosplayer.
Mentor. Actor.
It's time we take a step forward, come together,
and discover
how accepting our differences
can make us stronger.
I'll never forget the day our landlord called and said, read your lease. No pets allowed. My owner tells him my dog ate the lease, but that didn't work. And now I'm stuck in a shelter, but this pit bull is ready for a new crib. I'm loving, loyal, and play well with others. So don't be intimidated by all my muscles, because the biggest one I have is my heart. That's right, I said it.
She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. She gave them some broth without any bread and kissed them all soundly and put them to bed. Hunger is a story we can end. End it at feedingamerica.org.
Touchdown! Oh, did you see that?
Whoa, we scored?
Yeah, we scored. We're going to the playoffs.
I can't believe I missed that. Every time I'm buzzed, I spend too much time on my phone.
What?
I should take your phone away.
No. I'll call for a ride. Hey, why does my face look like that?
I'm playing with these new face filters.
Okay, you know what?
Yep, that's mine.
I'm going to need that back.
Nope.
Kevin!
The local Pop Bar Holidays announced the total amount that they raised this holiday season. After opening two locations in Fayetteville, Holidays raised over $55,000. Holidays raised this money for several local nonprofit organizations. These include the Children's Safety Center, NWA Center for Equality, and the Peace at Home Family Shelter.
For the second year in a row, Herman's Rib House has made a list of the finalists for the Arkansas Food Hall of Fame. The Fayetteville staple was selected from a list of over 2,000 submissions across the state. Herman's is the only restaurant to be nominated from Fayetteville. The winner will be announced this evening in Little Rock.
City officials are in favor of naming trails spanning 51 miles across Fayetteville. The city mobility coordinator, Dan Eifling, said that they are in the process of establishing branding across the trails. Eifling said each loop created will have its own unique features to help users navigate the path. The Walton Family Foundation awarded a grant of $385,000 that will be used for the Fayetteville's trails logos.
Coming off a win, men's basketball takes on a number one opponent. Find out how the Hogs might fare.
And gymnastics hit the floor for Equality Night. Find out which gym backs earned themselves careers hot next on UATV Sports.
Last week, Brandon met a girl on a dating app. One day after work, he finally found the courage to ask her out. No answer. He started to panic. Was he being too pushy? Maybe it was too...
Sorry I didn't respond. I was driving. I would love to go on a date. How does tonight sound?
Brandon tried to play it cool, but inside he knew. A girl so smart, so responsible. She must be a keeper.
COVID-19 has changed how we stomp the yard and feel the beat. Now it's time to take the first step that lets us get back to strolling instead of scrolling. Before we can safely come together, we need the facts. As COVID-19 vaccines become available, you may have questions.
Is it safe?
Should I get it? Is it free?
It's okay to have questions. Now get the facts about COVID-19 vaccines at getvaccineanswers.org so you can make an informed decision for yourself and for your fam.
Listen, you're my friend.
I noticed you haven't really been yourself recently.
Yeah, I feel like something's up.
How are you?
Are you okay?
Is there anything you want to talk about?
I just want to know how you're feeling.
And listen, even if you don't know what to say, I'm here to talk.
No matter what you're going through,
I just want you to know I'm here.
I've got your back. When you want to talk, I'm here.
Today, I'm going to talk to you about physics. Come on in, girls. Let's go. This is the first rocket to get humans to Mars.
Really tall.
I'm a rocket structural engineer, designing and building parts of the rocket. You are the generation that will be stepping foot on Mars. Do I have a group of astronauts on my hands?
Yes.
You can become a rocket scientist or whatever else you want to be.
Hello and welcome back to UATV Sports. I'm Ben Sawyers here with your latest sports news update. The Razorbacks men's basketball team extended their win streak to 8 in a 63-55 win over Mississippi State. It was a tale of two halves for the Hogs. In the first, Arkansas couldn't seem to get it going, shooting just under 27%. The struggle to score was apparent from deep, with the Razorbacks only draining one of their 13 attempts from long range. Both teams ended the first half tied at 25. However, Arkansas bounced back in the second half, making 48% of their shots and half of their three-pointers. Despite offensive struggles, the Razorbacks' defense held strong, grabbing 8 steals and causing 12 turnovers on the game. Now the Hogs look to take on the number one Auburn Tigers at home tomorrow night. Bruce Pearl and the Tigers are coming off a narrow 2-point victory over a Georgia team that currently sits at the bottom of the SEC standings. Arkansas will host the Auburn Tigers tomorrow night at Bud Walton Arena with tip-off set for 6 p.m. For all fans attending, the game will be a whiteout and doors will open at 4:30 p.m. Over at Barn Hill, the Gymbacks hosted Southeast Missouri for Equality Night. Freshman Leah Smith stood out with the highest all-around score on the night at 39.425. Smith recorded three personal bests on vault, floor, and bars. And senior Kennedy Hambrick pulled off a hat trick, placing first with season highs in vault and floor and a career high on beam. Junior Maddie Hickey earned her personal best in floor as well. Looking forward, the Gymbacks host the number 12 Kentucky Wildcats at Barn Hill February 11th. That meet marks the third Women's Empowerment Night, a tradition that began in Jordan Weaver's first season as head coach in 2020. And with softball season around the corner, two Razorback seniors were named preseason All-SEC in a recent coaches poll. First basewoman Danielle Gibson and pitcher Mary Half earned the honors. In her redshirt junior season, Gibson dominated on the offensive end, hitting 15 home runs and 51 RBIs. To cap off the season, Gibson was awarded All-SEC second team and All-Defensive Team accolades. Half had similar success on defense as the first Razorback to earn SEC Co-Pitcher of the Year. Arkansas opens the season on the road this Thursday against the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. And in national sports news, the NBA trade deadline is rapidly approaching. Teams will have until Thursday to make trades as they look to increase their playoff odds. Two teams hit the trade market already, with the Cleveland Cavaliers acquiring guard Caris LeVert from the Indiana Pacers. From the deal, the former Brooklyn Net will reunite with current Cavs big man Jared Allen. That's all for UATV Sports. We'll be back with more right after this break.
Well, now he's about to be caught. Oh, trouble!
As a race car driver for 40 years, I survived a lot of crashes.
Not everyone can run into a wall at 200 miles an hour and walk away. Without a seatbelt, I wouldn't be alive today. Now I'm retired, back home in Arkansas, driving my pickup. I'm shocked how many people aren't wearing seatbelts. Why risk your life when it only takes 2 seconds to buckle up? Take it from number 6. Buckle up, Arkansas.
A message from the Arkansas State Police Highway Safety Office.
Hopeless.
I know it was a joke, but it still hurt me.
Because of you, I felt wanted and not alone in this world.
Because you said hi to me on the first day of school, I felt included and I knew that I was going to be okay.
Give your town a reason to celebrate, because every Goodwill item you bring home brings job training and more to your community. Goodwill, bring good home.
Sanjay, you there?
Hey, David.
I'll make this quick. Listen, I have some questions.
What's on your mind?
This vaccine, I'm nervous. I got songs to write. Will I still be able to do that?
It'll be fine, David. Science is what you need. The vaccine is safe, my friend. It's gonna bring this pandemic to an end. See what I did there?
Okay, I trust it, thanks. Oh, and Sanjay, don't do that again.
David, I don't know. I thought I was spitting fire.
I hope y'all enjoyed the snow, because the sun is back. Tonight we have a low of 31 and you can expect a high of 59. But tomorrow you might need to break out your windbreaker as we'll have gusts of wind as high as 25 miles per hour, though you can expect a low of 30s and 60 all week long, so enjoy the warm weather. And that's all the time we have for UATV tonight. Thanks for joining us. I'm Kai Kocher.
And I'm Maddie Dunn. Have a great night.